In the past 25 years, every single day, while I used to live in another part that's not Kerala, that's in Karnataka, Bangalore, I had this one sweet moment called the summer holidays where I used to come down to Kerala with my parents. And when I used to come down, I was that kid sitting in the bus because we could only afford a bus journey. I was sitting in the bus and I'd wake up a little early, look out of the window while we were entering Kerala. And I'd still be that starry-eyed kid who looked at what was happening around me. Next 8 points are points that I've remembered that I always wanted to share about why I felt so great about being a part of this state, about meeting people from this state, about the things that we've done as a state, about the legacy that we've left behind as a state. The first aspect is the education in this state. And there are many people who talk about it, but education was at the core of Kerala right from the beginning because Kerala wanted this to be something that every person got as a right, irrespective of any economical background. Was what's even more exciting is to break education down into what we got as a state as a byproduct of that result was literacy. What does this give us as a benefit or as a blessing to this state? Let me break that down for you. The least infant mortality rate, highest life expectancy. We're also the most secular state because the first church, the first mosque, and the first synagogue existed in Kerala. The third and the most important one was banking and healthcare. When it told me that only state to have banks and hospitals in every village. And for a place this massive, for the number of people that it has, if this is the kind of infrastructure that Kerala has built for itself, I think it's genius. It's almost a case study to the world to see the kind of potential we have as a state. This is my most favorite part, community. You can go to any part of the world. You hear somebody speak in Malayalam, you literally be like, "Natla evadiya?" Kerala as a state has imbibed that feeling of togetherness no matter where you're from that one word that you speak out as a Malayali, you're already in that emotion of being together as a community, and that is beyond anything. We're also a state that is constantly innovating when it comes to storytelling and filmmaking formats. The kind of stories currently Kerala picks up in the film industry is absolutely phenomenal. We also have actors such as Mammootty and Mohanlal who are on the world's best list of actors of all time. I don't know how many of you have realized this about Kerala yet. It's art and culture being one of the most primary things that a state can represent outside of a limited ecosystem of science, commerce and arts. For Kochi being the first of its kind to build something like the Kochi Biennale. It is India's largest art exhibition and it's also Asia's biggest contemporary art festival. The seventh one is the epitome of everything that we've discussed till now. Last year, we as a state fought one of the biggest battles that we've ever fought. When the entire state was literally doubting what's going to happen to us, I was blown by the sense of ownership that each of us took towards saving this state and how we all took that responsibility because we knew how much it meant to be a part of this state. In a month and a half, we put out this hashtag. It said, "Kerala is open yet again to welcome people," because that's who we are. We're fighters. We're believers in making things happen. You know what I would walk back with today, if all of us started believing that about ourselves yet again? The floods was for the state, and there is a flood happening in your life every single day. You can fight it because you've seen better. Start being proud yet again about this beautiful state that we are part of, because we are goddamn awesome. And so are you as an individual, as a part of this state. Let me wrap this beautiful moment by saying one thing. You don't meet a Malayali, they happen to you. Thank you so much. My name is Anto.